The HomePod Mini is a great little smart speaker. If you're thinking of buying one and you're wondering how difficult it is to set up, or you have one and you need help, let me show you how. And if you find this video useful, please like and subscribe for more good content. Let's begin. Okay, so the HomePod Mini is really easy to set up. All you need is your iPhone or iPad nearby, which is required to transfer over your Apple profile details and settings to it. Take the HomePod out the box. Place it in an area with about 15 centimeters of space around it. This is to allow the sound waves to come out without obstruction. Attach the plug to the USB cable. Plug it in to a mains power outlet. As soon as you do this, a light on the LCD panel on the top will come on and swirl around. Then you will hear a welcome sound. Make sure your iPhone or iPad is unlocked and move it next to the HomePod. The HomePod is able to detect it when it's nearby and then it can communicate with it. An information card will appear on your screen that says HomePod Mini. Tap the Setup button. The next card will ask, what room is HomePod in? HomePod needs to know so that it can fulfill room-specific requests. It's especially helpful if you have multiple units. You can ask it to turn the lights on in here and it will know which room you mean. Spin the wheel to view the different room types. Living room is the default option. Then select continue. If you're not already a subscriber to Apple Music, you will be prompted to join. You can do this by selecting the subscribe button. If you don't want to, select not now. Next, you're prompted to allow the HomePod to use your Siri voice profile from your iPhone or iPad so it can recognize your voice and play your music and podcasts and more. If you select don't recognize my voice, Siri will still be able to answer a non-personal request. Select recognize my voice. Personal request. If you transfer your voice profile, you are given the option to allow personal request. This means you can allow Siri on the HomePod to access your personal information, such as your messages, reminders, and calendar, and to make phone calls and send text messages when your iPhone or iPad is nearby, but only if your voice is recognized. Select Use Personal Request. If you share a home with others, Siri can recognize their voices too, allowing them to have access to their own custom music, calendars, and other personal information. After HomePod is set up, they will receive a notification about this. Select Continue. Terms and conditions are the rules you must agree to abide by when using the HomePod and iCloud. To read them all, select View Terms and Conditions. Press Agree to continue. The Accounts and Settings card is used to transfer your Wi-Fi code and your Apple account settings to the HomePod. Select Transfer Your Settings. And lastly, there is an exciting step to take. You must authorize the pairing of your two devices. The HomePod sends out a password using light from the LCD panel, and you must hold your iPhone or iPad camera over it to read it. This is a clever security step to check that both devices are near each other. As soon as that's done, you will hear a confirmation chime. Siri will then introduce itself and give you suggestions on what you can ask.
Hi, I'm Siri. Welcome to HomePod.
Once you've done that, you're ready to get started and have fun. If this was helpful to you, remember to like, subscribe, and share. Cheers.